Hey guys, what up? It's GooseTV here again today, and today I'm back with another Madden Mobile video on my channel. Now today's video, guys, we are talking about the Madden Mobile 21 season in general. Yesterday on Reddit, I posted a huge, almost an essay on the game, different areas of the game, talking about my frustrations, suggestions, just kind of talking about everything with the game, how it's gone this year, obviously hasn't been exactly how we've wanted, so I think it's super important for some people to kind of voice their complaints and concerns with the game, offer feedback, that kind of stuff, and I really want to be able to do that with the platform that I do have. So this is going to be the video form of my post on Reddit from yesterday. I will leave a link in the description to that if you would like to go check that out. Super long, but I don't know how long this video is going to be, but I'm just going to talk and we'll see where we can go from there. If you guys are new to the channel, make sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on my post notifications so you never miss any of my videos. 70% of you guys aren't subscribed, so please hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. Let's try to get this video to 200 likes. Before we start, I am going to put a link in the description for a Google form. I created a brand new Google form where you're going to be able to input two different things. I want you guys to give one suggestion of how to improve the game from this year to next year, what they can do, one change that you think they should make to, you know, add on to 21 to make it better for 22. But I also want you to put for the next question, you know, a new idea that you might come up with. What is something new that they could add to Madden Mobile 22 to make it better? I want to compile a huge list of responses, and then we'll be able to make some wishlist videos here over the next few months as we get on to Madden Mobile 22. So, Madden Mobile 21, like I said, has not been the greatest. For some people, it's been maybe somewhat decent. Like, you know, there's different parts of it that are going to be good, different parts of it that are going to be bad. But I'm going to start off kind of with my perspective of the game, where, because this is all stuff that I think is from my perspective. I'm not a competitive player. I do not play Arena very much. I'm not in a competitive league. I focus very heavily on somewhat building my team, building, you know, coins, and for the most part, anything that I can do to make content on the game, that's what I focus on in the game. I'll buy the field passes, I'll buy a couple things every, you know, every once in a while, and that helps me make content. So that is, I basically, the reason that I'm playing this game is to be able to make videos, and the thing is, this year, that's even difficult, and I'm going to get to that later on in the video, but that's kind of where I'm at for the game. But in general, there's a lot of things that I've been talking about recently on streams, and I just wanted to put them all in one place, all in one video. I've played this game for a long time. I played this back in Madden Mobile 15 a little bit, but not much. I really started playing a lot more in 16, posted videos in Madden Mobile 17. The very start of Madden Mobile 17 is basically when my channel started, and I've been pretty much posting videos ever since then. So I've been through a lot of the super fun parts of the game and the not so fun parts of the game. So I've been here for a while. I think I have some ideas for what could make the game better, but like I said, I just want to talk about what my frustrations are with the game right now. And the biggest thing is, the game is boring and it really doesn't focus on fun. There's not much to do in the game. It's just, like I said, it's not fun. It's so grindable. The focus is on building a team and being competitive. That is the only thing to focus on. There's nothing fun about grinding the same live events and the same promos over and over again. And that's kind of the biggest thing I think about this game right now, is the boring parts of it. It's impossible to find any fun in the game for the most part. There's no fun sets. There's no fun events. The promos are the exact same over and over again, which we'll talk to. You know, it's the same stuff over and over again. It feels like a chore to log on almost every single day until you check out a promo. You're like, okay, this is the same thing, that kind of stuff. So let's talk about the cards in the games and the promos. This is like a big thing that I talk about actually a lot about the game. The cards in the game and the promos are the only way to be able to get cards in the game, right? So promos are consistently the very best cards in the game, and your team is going to consist of these promo players, and that's it. There's no other area of the game that rewards a card that is anywhere near on your team. The only thing that gets close to that is Master Series, which we'll talk about, which does not even come close to being rosterable for, you know, most of the people. If you can keep up and have a team with the promos and everything like that, the field passes, I would argue, are tied to the promos. There's not a single card. Master Series cards aren't going to fit on your team. It's all promo cards. I really think that needs to be different. You know, fan favorites could have been something like that, but those weren't updated. We'll once again talk about that. We have a lot of things to talk about. This might be a longer video. But like I said, there is so much that there should be when it's only promos. Master Series doesn't catch up. There are no set players other than promo players. The fan favorites, there's nothing like that. Like I said, the Master Series, there are no cards other than promo cards. So there's almost no reason to grind any other area of the game. And that's what makes the promos so boring. We're so focused on the promos that when the promos don't give us enough to do, we think it's the promos' fault. When what it should be is we should have other areas of the game that should reward us with players so that we can, you know, focus less on the promos so we can enjoy the promos more, if that makes sense. The way to make promos better is to make the other areas of the game better. We need to bring stuff back for Madden Today. Madden Today, there is almost no point for a lot of people. For me, I don't care too much about having a high power team. I know it's important, but once again, I don't focus on gameplay that much. I don't want to grind XP and legends. I don't do my daily goals half the time. There's no reason for me to play Madden Today. My stamina is just sitting here. I want to be able to bring back some of the old just live events that we had for the different types of players. What about the Royals, the Veterans, the Game Changers, those kind of cards where you can just get them from events or get collectibles for them and trade those in for very simple promo players. Being able to, like I said, do that kind of stuff. What about like something simple like Road to the Ring, where you play an event, you get a collectible, and need to collect different collectibles to get a player. Super simple sets like that need to be coming back to Madden Today to be able to make some fun players. Flashback players, which we'll talk about. Another big thing for leagues. I'm not going to talk too much about leagues because my league isn't competitive. I'm not in the top 100. I'm not part of that group. I know there's a very large, a big part of the community right now is league versus league players that are in the top leagues. They're very competitive. They spend a lot of money on the game. That's not me, so I'm not going to talk too much about it. But one thing that I do know that will even increase the player base by a little bit is having those league versus league players back. Remember back in Madden Mobile 16 and 17 where we had league versus league players, where everybody in the league, if you grinded for a certain milestone, whether it be 20,000 yards as a league or 200,000 yards, whatever it was, I don't remember what it was, you needed a certain amount of yards or a certain amount of points or whatever it was, and your whole team got a player for your team. Everybody got, you know, whether it was a 95 Patrick DeMarco. I feel like those league versus league players would really help drive the player base up. Think about it. If you're in a league that's kind of at the bottom and it's not super active, and you have these league versus league players you want to grind for, first of all, it's going to make people want to actually grind it. But then you tell your friends, hey, my league is getting this card, or we want to grind for this card. You should get the game, join my league, start grinding. We can get this card for our teams together. That stuff helped out so much, and that made the leagues actually pretty exciting to join and move around with. I think those kind of cards really need to be back in the game. Like I said, I think it would bring a lot of people back into the game. And then, like I said, the other set players, we don't have anything else. We used to have like team captains, which, you know, very similar to fan favorites. Fan favorites would have been fine. This whole point that I would be talking about would not even matter if we had fan favorites that updated throughout the rest of the year. If these got up to the higher overall cards, I wouldn't be complaining if we could put these on our team at this point in the game, because they were fine to put on our team earlier in the game. I made a video earlier in the year, about a month into the game, talking about the game so far, and we were completely fine. We thought fan favorites were sweet, but then they didn't update them literally since September, so that kind of ruins that whole point. But that would have helped out so much. We just need more set players to be able to grind. Obviously, Legends and Ultimate Legends were a bit of a bust this year, but that just more of a design. It's not like it was a flaw in the game. It was just more, if they designed it better, it would have been fine, if that makes sense. But for the most part, there's just were no set players. And then one of the bigger things that I wanted to, you know, include in the game is having the Mobile Masters and the Domination Masters back. And the focus on these needs to be that they're the best players in the game. If you're getting these cards, they're going to be on your end game team. When I talk about a Mobile Master, I mean you grind every area of the game. You're grinding live events, you're grinding promos, you're grinding seasons, you're grinding leagues, you are doing sets. All of those things contribute toward completing this mobile master, you know, you don't get it for many months into the game unless you are a super heavy grinder who gets it, you know, December or something like that. The goal is to try, it's going to take most of the year to be able to get this card, but it needs to be an end game card with good boosts on your team, but it's going to be on your team for the end. And then what about the domination and the, you know, that kind of stuff, or conquerors in Madden Mobile 18, those kind of fun events that reward a very good card. We don't have anything like that. It's just promos. We have Master Series, which does not live up to the hype. The promos this year have been kind of meh, right? They've been very similar, all the same things over and over again. The same style of promo, the same events. There's only been a couple promos that have been a little bit different than one another. New Year's was a little bit different collectible-wise, which I thought was pretty cool, and it ended up being a promo where you could get a lot of Masters anyways. Pro Bowl was a very similar event style, but you could actually get a bunch of Masters because you got enough collectibles for all of the Masters. The way to get Masters this year is, you can only get enough collectibles from the live events that you know you're given to complete one or two Masters, and then from there you have to spend to be able to get anything else. In recent games, how it's worked is you get enough collectibles. It's just if you have enough players, which you can just buy off the auction house to complete more Masters. That's not a thing this year. You are very, very limited to what Masters you can get. So you know, is that the best idea? I don't think so. I don't know what is the best idea. I know in the older games the Masters were set up a whole lot differently, where literally you just needed a couple elite players that you could just buy off the auction house. The Masters were super cheap, some of the better players in the game, but once again, the whole focus of the game was not on promos, so that didn't matter too much. So once again, I don't know if that's the best way to go around it, but the field passes have been a little bit different this year as well. We'll talk about those here in a second, but you know, the best way to get players is going to be your field passes and your promos, and I really think that that needs to change. Let's talk a little bit about the laziness of the devs and the way that this game has gone out. I think the biggest thing for me is when they revealed the game to us, you know, last June, July, before the game came out in August, there were two things that they focused pretty heavily on, or a couple major points that they talked about: Master Series and the Core Loop. First of all, they called the Master Series the backbone of the game. If it's the backbone of the game, it should be the best part of the game. It should reward the best players. It should not be, you know, left behind so we get cards that are not on our team in a few months. The Lamar Jackson should be the very best player in the game throughout the year if they're going to do that upgrade system like they have. It needs to be the backbone of the game if you're going to say it's the backbone of the game. It has not been even, most people don't even play it because it's not worth it. It literally is not worth playing, and it's the backbone of the game. That's garbage. And then they also came out with the core loop idea where you're recycling and using all these things and the crafting system. It was new. It was cool. We got all these different collectibles. We're like, wow, that's pretty cool. And it actually was. They used it for Fired Up. They used it for like the first month, maybe. Obviously, the fan favorites included some of the team badges. But other than that, other than evolving, which is not even worth it and horrible this year, this hasn't been used at all. I don't understand why. Now, I made a good comparison here where this is very similar to the trophy system we had in the old games. We just had bronze, silver, golden elite trophies that you could get from different areas of the game, and those were just used in random sets to help out with the cost of the sets. It's the same thing. I think the trophies would be even easier, so there's not a ton of different collectibles, and it's just easier to keep up with throughout the year, I think. The trophy system worked very well. It kept different areas of the auction house and the game stimulated. Like I said, it helped out with different sets, so the cost wouldn't be too cheap, because you knew the cost of what these different trophies were, and they were used throughout the year in a bunch of different things. So this core loop could have been utilized so much more, and it was a huge talked about thing. This was supposed to be the way that the game was going to work this year, and it just was not followed up upon. And then I talked about the fan favorites. The fan favorites weren't updated this year, which just makes no sense. We had a good start, and I think we were going to have a good way that we're going to go all the way up to 100 overall, and they just do not do it. They say we're going to do it, we're going to update it, and they don't update it. It just makes no sense to put something in the game like this and just let it sit. And it's still at the front of the sets. It's still looking at, you know, it's looking at us right in the face, right here. And it literally does nothing for us. It hasn't been updated. It's just a reminder of how lazy it is to just put something like this in the game and just not finish it. It doesn't make any sense. Another thing I want to talk about is the glitches in the game. Obviously, almost every single promo that comes out has some glitch. Some of them have been much worse than others this year. If any testing has been done on the game, I wouldn't believe it, because there's no possible way that any of the promos are tested before they come out. I know that there's some sort of document where they have all of the requirements of the different sets and the rewards and everything like that. If one person were able to go on, you know, before the promo come out, test it a day early, verify that each set is giving exactly what it should take 15 minutes, play every event, make sure it's giving out what it should, none of these glitches would have happened this year, but not a single one of them, I guarantee you, were tested at all. Why would you put out a product that is not tested at all? Because, like I said, there's no way that these game-breaking glitches were found beforehand. They realize afterwards, the Martin Gate, obviously, being the biggest one, that was just, you know, awful. There's no way that that should be in the game ever. There's no way that that should be, like, it breaks the game. You know, that was bad. We're lucky that it didn't, you know, something else even worse didn't happen, because you know, at this rate, it definitely could. I don't think there's enough people playing the game to the point where it would really mess up too much. But the game needs to be tested and make sure that the product that you're putting out actually doesn't break when you're using it. I think that's kind of a general thing, but just hasn't been a thing this year for the game, and it needs to change. So let's move on to the creator side of things. I'm a YouTube creator. I've made Mad Mobile content for years, and you can see the shift in my content this year. Usually I'm able to do some fun series with opening packs. I like to do pack openings. I like to make coin making methods. I like to do all this, but this year it has been how to do this, how to do that, and promos that is starting to get very old. Doesn't do well in videos anymore because everyone knows what to do. The game is not focused on content creators, and obviously you're not going to cater it completely around content creators. However, I do think that is a way to make your game more popular and have a larger player base. If you people that are going to be making videos on the game are a form of advertisement, in my opinion, and if they fail to see that, then they are missing out, because you see all these other games that realize that their creators are huge. Epic Games obviously is a big deal with Fortnite. They knew how big their creators were. They work with their creators. They've supported creator codes. I'm not saying something like that needs to come to Madden Mobile, but I'm saying that they realize that their creators are a huge part of their game. Fortnite blew up because of social media and everything like that, and Madden Mobile did as well when it happened. But this game is not catered towards that. There's no fun set packs. There's no flashback packs. There's no large quick sells. The packs in the game, there's no packs in the game, which we'll talk about in a second. There's nothing fun to open. Every single promo pack is the exact same. You don't have chances of pulling anything good. It's not catered towards creators, and this year they took a step more towards obviously trying to prevent. I don't know exactly what they were preventing, but you're not allowed to make more than one account. That hurts me, because then I can't do a second account to make videos on. And once again, that kind of thing, they're trying to stop certain, you know, I don't know if it's hacking or if it's, you know, hopping and that kind of stuff. But for the most part, it hurts the content creation side of things. I think multiple lineups might end up coming into the game next year, which would help a lot content wise. But like I said, I think if they were able to focus a lot more on people being able to post things about the game and talk about the game and the fun parts of the game, which there really isn't anything, it's just grind, 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 it's not fun, then we'd be able to have a much better game. And I think that's something that they really need to focus on. And then once again, packs. I know that wasn't the thing that they were focusing on this year, but that is once again one of the things that makes the game fun and exciting and brings people into the game. The pro packs, you can't pull anything past October in. They're boring. The regular packs, there's no fun packs, there's no limited time players in packs. You can't pull anything good out of packs. Packs just aren't a good thing this year that need to be changed. We need to be able to pull some fun stuff out of them. They need to be updated frequently if you're going to do it. Like right now, we should not be able to only pull players from October in our core packs right now. I'm willing to bet that they don't update these for the rest of the year. I'm willing to bet that they're going to be lazy and not update these for the rest of the year. So we'll see. But packs need to be better this year. Need to be better this year, including like the fun set packs, like the random flashback players, random players where you have a chance of making profit or losing a ton of coins, large quick sells, that kind of stuff. I want to be able to make more content, have more fun with the game. Let's move on to an area talking about pay to win versus free to play and the way that this game has gone that way. So let me talk about my opinion on this aspect. So in a game, I truly believe that obviously spending, this game focuses a lot on the competitive advantage, and that's the way that EA games work. That's the way this game is always going to work. However, forcing people to stay competitive by spending isn't the best way to go around it, in my opinion. Once again, maybe I don't know the best way for this. I'm not the company executive. I don't know exactly what they, you know, will do to make money. I don't know how they should make money. I'm not telling them how they should make money either. But I'm just saying, my opinion is that I would much rather have a large, happy player base that is willing to spend little, smaller amounts every once in a while than forcing people to stay competitive right now with a smaller group spending a lot of money. I think the large player base, the happy player base that are willing to spend money on the game because it's fun is the most important part. And the thing that I mentioned in the Reddit post is that Fortnite, for example, there is not a single item in that game that gives a competitive advantage other than maybe skins that blend in on accident or something like that. And they've tried to take that away because obviously those do give competitive advantage at times. But the focus of it is that does not give you a competitive advantage. It is purely looks. It does nothing for your game, but people are willing to spend money on that game because it is fun and because they enjoy the game. And I guarantee you, people don't spend money on Mad Mobile because they enjoy it. That is the main thing that I want to say. That is something that I think is so important. If people are having fun in the game, regardless if it looks fun or not, or regardless if it gives you a competitive advantage or not, people are going to spend money on the game. And, you know, we have this stuff from the yard, these jerseys. Why can't we use these in the main game? I guarantee you, people would spend money on these. Regardless, you know, the game's not bad, but the game's not good this year, right? So I guarantee you people would spend these if you could use them for your ultimate team. Why happen? That was a huge missed opportunity this year. And honestly, I think we could see it next year. I really think we could see this next year. But they really missed it this year. I'm telling you right now, they missed a huge opportunity to be able to use these things in the main game. People would spend money on it. You saw how many people bought like the draft logos and that kind of stuff. So that's pretty huge. But then there's a free-to-play advantage that is so great this year, including the main field pass. Now, I buy the field passes and I completely agree that this is way too big of an advantage. We are split down the middle. Free-to-play players get extra stuff, right? Extra stuff that's going to help you even more. You're getting, obviously, more Madden cash, Madden Max tokens. You're getting more Madden cash. You get extra players. You get reduction of the auction house tax. You get extra boost for your team. Like, you get way too much extra stuff. Way too much extra stuff from the field pass. And that's coming from me, a field pass user. The gap between the free-to-play and the pay-to-play is way too high. Way too high. And free-to-plays, it's very hard to keep up with. And I know there are some free-to-plays that are, you know, towards the top or in competitive leagues. But trust me, they're still at a disadvantage. And for most people, they're not willing to spend 10 hours a day on this game to be able to stay, you know, keep up. And for most people, that's not just going to happen. So I think, I don't know exactly what to do because obviously that's the point of this game. That's what power came from. That's what program stamina, gems, it all stems back to EA making revenue. Become a pay-to-win game because they need to be able to make the revenue for the game. At least that's what I think. Maybe I'm completely off, but that's like, you know, I think that's kind of more of a common knowledge thing at this point. So finding a way to reduce that gap, I think it's just way too high right now. I think the field pass is way too much compared to what, and you know, I don't think the answer is forcing people to pay money to stay competitive. I really think it's putting fun stuff in the game for us to use. And like I said, if the game is good, people will be willing to spend money on it, regardless if it gives you a competitive advantage or not. Power has been in the game purely for a pay-to-win aspect and a competitive advantage, and it is one of the... Think about this. You have a better team than someone, you should be able to beat them, right? But if you have a better team that has higher power, because if you have a better team, in general, you're going to have higher power. You get an extra overall boost because of that. It just doesn't make any sense. This was the biggest complaint from last year, and it was the first thing that they told us was going to be in the game this year. You can't do that as a company. If your entire player base is, you know, completely against something like that, and you tell them that, yeah, it's going to be in the game next year, sorry, that's awful. It's something that everybody hates. It's obviously a full revenue strategy to be in the game. It just doesn't make sense. It's people do not like power. It's, you know, one thing that I mentioned, I understand companies have to do something new, right? Companies that they can't just release Madden Mobile 16 every single year. They can't do that because then people are going to leave the game regardless. You have to come up with new things. Power was just not it. It's not it. It's just too much. It's too much moving, too many moving pieces. You have to worry about your scheme and your coach and all this. It's just become way too complex. I want to be able to put a player on my team team because I want to, and it, you know, somehow fits on my team for my overall, not because its power is too low, right? Or, you know, I want to put on a card player on my team because the card art is cool. Not have to worry about, oh, the it's a free card, the power was too low. This kind of sucks, it can't go on my team. I hate that. I want to be able to make a team however I want to make a team, regardless of its power. The auction house is obviously a big issue right now because it's nowhere near what it used to be. It's no longer a player-run auction house, and that's been like for the last few years, and it's not going to revert back to its old, you know, old player-to-player auction house. It's just not going to because of what happened with coin selling and that kind of stuff. What do they do about the auction house? I think the auction house has been better this year. You can sell cards, but the thing is, you can only really sell cards with your bid, which means you have to wait a full 4 hours. You used to be able to post something up. If you wanted some quick coins, you could post something on the auction house for a cheap buy now. It would get bought, and you could have your coins in even 5 minutes if you posted it low enough, you know, half an hour, whatever. You have to wait a full 4 hours for anything to sell in this game, which is very boring. It's way too long to wait. I don't know what they can do with the bot to be able to make it buy items now. I don't think that's, you know, like I said, I don't know what the solution is for that. If they go more back to, if they scale the bot back so it's a little bit more player run to run. I don't know how the bot exactly works for the most part. So I don't know what they do with the auction house, but I don't think it's in a horrible state right now. But it's just, it's not as fun because it's, you know, there's not pure sniping. It's not player to player. It's just not super fun. And then the way that the auction house has worked this year is because the masters are so hard to get, the masters go for a lot of coins. Well, we're also able to make a ton of coins because the way the game this works this year. But then also players like gold players and things like that go for absolutely nothing. We need something to simulate the prices of these gold players, these silver players that have literally no value. You can't sell them on the auction house for anything right now. They need some value. And that's where like something like trophies would come in. The way the trophies used to work is the gold players would still have value because you could snipe the gold players, you could put the gold players in a trophy set, and you would get a random number of trophies out. We need something like that, or some sort of exchange where gold players are useful to keep them up on the auction house, because like I said, the top players in the game are going for 30 million and then you can't even sell the gold players for like 500 coins, or at least you might be able to, something like that, but you kind of get my point. The gold players barely sell and they have no reason to be in the game because obviously no one's going to put them on your team, and they don't go into any set for any reason. So we need something like that to be able to fix the auction house in that point. And then my last few points I want to talk about complaint wise are that, like I said, the jerseys and stadiums. I think the main reason we didn't have a lot of that kind of stuff in the game this year is they focused a lot of stuff on the yard. I could be completely wrong on that, but I think jerseys and stadiums and that kind of thing. I talked about the jerseys, which I think they could easily do next year. But stuff like that, people care about. People care about having jerseys and stadiums. When they play, they want to look good. They want stuff to look good. So that kind of stuff is huge. So if you can, you know, if you can make people happy with that kind of stuff, that's a big plus. I guarantee you there's been a number of people that have left the game this year because they can't get their jerseys or they can't get fun stadiums. I guarantee you a few people have left because of that. This is more of a minor thing, but the overall cap I think is more of a look thing. I don't know if the overall cap should be 105. It's kind of a random number. I liked it better when there was just a 99 cap. I would even be fine if 100s were the best players in the game, but I think 99 or 100 should be the overall cap for the most part. Season mode has no, when, you know, once again, the rewards aren't good enough in any area of the game, and the season mode is no exception. There's no good rewards in season. The only reason you're grinding seasons are if for whatever reason you like the gameplay and you just want to play the game, or you're grinding it for the season points for the field passes. There's not much else to talk about other than that in that case. And then evoing cards this year just doesn't make sense. The cost is way too high for just one card. It becomes unauctionable. You can only evo it one time. Like, you know, 99 Dwayne Brown costs 396 plus. I don't know exactly what that costs, but for a one, especially for the 99s up to 100s, for a one overall boost that only is going to increase my awareness plus one, my run block plus one, and my pass block plus one, not do any other stat upgrades, and I have to pay this much, then I can't sell the card if I have a player that replaces it. Evolving makes no sense to me. I've only evolved two players that I know for sure I wanted to keep on my team for a very long time. The Tyreek Hill I wanted to evolve because I wanted the 99 speed. The stuff Fon Gilmore I won in a giveaway, so I evoed it so I couldn't sell it. I haven't evolved anything else because it's just not worth, it's a waste of coins this year. So evolving system last year worked a lot better. I actually really liked the evolving system last year because you could have some of the, you know, the early promo players on your team from a while ago, and I really like that kind of part of it. So that is my kind of complaints and my few positive parts about the game this year that I will say. I'm glad stat booster back. Something random Jerry mentioned in the comments. sense is that the thing is, as much as it looks like fun, the stat boosts are once again a pay-to-win thing because they only boost the promo players themselves. And the way that the games work this year is that the promo players, you can only get one or two free to play. The pay-to-wins are going to be the ones that are getting multiple. And because they boost each other, if you have a lot of players from the same promo, you're getting big boosts on the cards. I didn't really think of that. That is a great point, Jerry. And it, you know, it's true, but hopefully we can get some more team-wide boosts back into the game. Yeah, like I said, team-wide boosts would be very, very nice to have back in the game. Hopefully they add something like that back next year if they're able to bring that stuff back. Tournaments were in the game this year, so that's really fun. I'm glad tournaments were back. It was something fun to do for some of the weeks that we had them. You know, maybe they weren't the best setup. Obviously, every once in a while, they were stuck on rookie mode, which isn't any fun. But I'm glad they added tournaments, and I'm hoping they can continue that kind of format this year, or, you know, next year, because we know, for the most part, the field pass tournaments are done, but we still have, you know, like the every other weekend, like the training point tournaments and stuff like that. I mentioned you can actually sell stuff on the auction house this year, and then the card art this year arguably is some of the best card art we've ever had. Very big shout out to the art team for making some sweet card art this year, which is a big part of the game for me. I love the promos, I love the players, I love the card art on the, I like to, you know, collect players from different promos. I don't focus too much on building the best possible team that I can. I like having fun with the game. I like looking at things that are fun to look at. And that is my opinion, and that is my rant. That is my full thoughts on Madden Mobile 21. Remember, go click the link in my description. Take the little survey thing. I want to have compile as many responses as I possibly can to talk about Madden Mobile 22. We'll be coming out with a lot more videos, obviously, over the next few months talking about our wish list for Madden Mobile 22. We'll probably be getting some news at some point here for when Madden Mobile 22 might be coming out, what we might be expecting for it. We might get season score soon, all that stuff, hopefully very, very soon. But I really hope you guys did enjoy the video. Let's have a conversation in the comments below. I'd love to chat with you guys on a lot of these topics. Let me know what you guys have to say. Let me know your thoughts on this type of video. If you'd like to see this more, these more videos every once in a while, I like making these videos. I like talking. I think voicing opinions about the game is a very important aspect, and people like me and other YouTubers and other big players in the game really need to start doing more of this kind of stuff, I think, so we can actually get some, hopefully some change and have a better Madden Mobile 22. Today's post notification shout out goes out to Samuel Boss. Be the first person to comment on a video for the next video's post notification shout out. But anyways, guys, that is just about it for the video. I hope you guys did enjoy it. If you did, make sure to like it and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I'm GooseTV, and I'm out. I will see you guys later.